For the fuse, you have to think about sanding in multiple dimensions. Before we sand this, we should mark a couple points on the top of the glider as to where the wings will be and as to where the tail will be. On the very top, we're going to measure 2¾ inches and draw a line. That will be the leading edge of the wing. And then 2 inches from there, since that is the cord, we'll draw another line. Okay? And I kind of forgot what this one will be for the tail. It is 9 3/8. Let's go with that. So we'll measure out 9 3/8. Right there. And the width of the tail is 1½ inches. Right there, which should probably give us about 1 inch for a fingertip to pull back on the catapult launcher. Great. Okay. Where I like to start on sanding is the underside. If you notice, the tail is much thinner than the body, but I prefer to smooth out the edges a little bit and make it a little bit more rounded. So we're going to start off with the bottom, and we're going to taper it down a little bit from here, and we're going to taper it down to the trailing edge just a little bit more. So I'll use the rough side of my sander a little bit and just kind of work my way in there. I'll even get the edges a little bit. Notice I'm sanding the tail a little bit more right here like this and less up here. I don't want to overdo this. If you get it too thin, it's going to be too floppy. Do a little bit more. Okay. So that's one dimension, is the underside. Now we're going to sand one side, and we're also going to sand the other side, but you have to keep it balanced. So I kind of like to count my strokes, starting from the bottom up, work my way up, and then I'll flip it over and do it as well. So pretty much like this. There we go. And that creates a little bit of a taper effect, and that also lessens the weight on the tail. Again, the less weight on the tail, the less weight you have to add to the nose. So keeps your glider light. Okay, so now we go to the front part. Now I created these marks, and it's very important. I'll also draw some lines here, that this is where the wing will go, and also this is where the tail will go. We do not want to sand in these zones right here. We want to keep them nice and flat. That way our wings will glue very nicely. Okay, so let's just go ahead and round off the belly of the plane a little bit. Pretty much the same concept. Get a little bit like this. I'm gonna work my way to the nose. I'll round off the nose. Round off the edges here, and the edges. Now, I do not want to sand around the zone, so I'll only go up to that point. It's all about aerodynamics, really, keeping it smooth. And then I'll go to the finer sander a little bit. Round this off a little bit. And then in this notch area, I'll take my little sander like this and just kind of take off the rough edges. some places that I can't quite get, I'll use a little strip of sandpaper. And I like to round off my shark tooth a little bit so it doesn't cut into my the rubber band. There we go. Now, it's optional whether you want to sand the top part here between the trailing edge of the wing and the leading edge of the tail. You can do that if you like. I really haven't noticed much difference in the glider flights, whether you do it or not. It's up to you. And now the tail itself, you can also kind of round it off if you like. Now, if you sand it too thin, you will run a risk of actually making it too flexible and breaking. So there's no real harm in kind of keeping a little bit thickness, but you definitely kind of want to keep it smooth and rounded, and you'll find out that performance-wise, it's great. All right, so let's move on to the tail. Tail's pretty simple. I think we need to trim up the leading tips here a little bit. Now, what we want to do with the tail, there's no real difference between the top part of the tail and the bottom, so we want to keep everything equal. So as many strokes as we sand on the top, we want to sand on the bottom. So I'm going to start off with a little bit of the rougher sandpaper, and let's see if I can show you right here. The idea is that I want to thin out the trailing edge up to this point right here and just create these a little bit thinner. I want to have a little bit control, some elevator control. So these trailing edges need to thin out so I can actually bend them up and bend them down should I need to trim my glider. So we'll start that off like this. And try to do what you do on the top. As you do on the bottom. Don't want to get too crazy. This glider flies great with little trimming, but should trimming be necessary, we do want to have a little control over that. This seems pretty good. If it's too flimsy, then you could have bad effects on the airplane. All right, so for the front, I'm going to use this sander, and I want to kind of round off let's start with here. Round off the edges. Curve them up. Now I'm going to take off the sharp edges. And again, what you do for one side, you do the same for the other side. Okay, there we have a nice tail, and we'll move on to the main wing. First off, I'm going to sand kind of a tapering effect. I want to make it thinner from the center point right here to the edge, so I want it to be a little bit thinner. How I do that is using the rough sandpaper block. Kind of work my way in. And duplicate that very motion, the very same sanding strokes on the other side. Next step is to thin it from the leading edge down to the trailing edge, and we want to pretty much sand the full length of the wing itself to thin that out. This does take some time. Want to keep a check on the thickness, make certain you're balanced. All right, at this point, I'm going to flip it over as I want to create a under camber effect. So I use my smaller sandpaper, 220 grit, and I want to sand just right here. Give it a quick smooth over. And I'll use this smoother sandpaper to also sand the top. Okay, now we need to round the edges, the front edges. As I draw the sandpaper, I gradually bring it down lower and lower and lower, like that. Starts off kind of high like this, and I go lower and lower and lower. I don't want this too thin. I want some stiffness so that it doesn't flop around when I launch it. But now you want to sand a little bit. This is the underside. You want to sand a little bit on the underside like this.